Welcome back to the Nikki Clarke Radio Show here on WeAreHotline.net. It's 11 a.m., and we have another fantastic person coming on the line. She is a woman in the community who is involved in event planning, and she's also entering into ministerial work. Please welcome on the show Elizabeth Lakatos. Elizabeth, Happy New Year.
Happy New Year, Nikki. Thank you so much. You have a chance talking with me, and I'm so glad to talking to you over the phone.
Oh, thank you. It's a blessing. And I'm so grateful that you have the time for us today. So let's get right into it. I'm sure the listeners want to know a little bit about your background. So tell us about how you started and the name of your company.
Wow, it's a very good question. But before I give you the answer, I have a little story with that. My background is Hungarian, and I came to Canada in 2001 with six kids and my husband.
Six children. Wow.
Yes. And thanks for God, when we are living here after 2 years, when we came, I got in 2002 and 2003, one baby, and 2003 the other one. So we have eight kids. And the truth is,
wow.
Yeah, we are an eight kids family. So first of all, I'm a big mama. And my husband doing a complete home remodeling. I'm spending time with him so many times because what I learned from my country, my education, I'm finished and I'm interior designer. And I worked with him a couple of years. I got some experience. But when I came to Canada, I didn't speak English. So I just have to learn and have to study it well. How can I explain everything just well, how I just did before in my language? So it takes time, but the truth is, after when we are stand up here and my life is much stronger from the beginning, we got a chance to go and travel to United States, to Miami. And there is happened a very big tragedy, which is 5 years ago, I lost one of my son over there. And what we went through is very, very deep, and one of my son, who is 15 years old, he's a crime victim and witness on the case, is a criminal case, and three Cuban guys tried to rob my children, and one of them is killed my son with gun. It's
a very, very deep
story, and after when we came back to Canada, how we continue everything is very, very, very hard. But the truth is, thanks for God, we are Christian, and we try to stand up by faith. And my son, who is in the heaven now, he always respect my job. He always like what I did and how I decorating my house and people house. And I always have a chance to help for other people. And he always believe me I able to doing this and do this for serious wise. And this is what gave me a power to stand up and doing that, because this is his wish. And the truth is, I praying for God, and I'm asking the Lord, if I really need to do this, please help me, Lord, what kind of name I can choose? And the Lord is put something in my heart with the Holy Spirit, and I got a chance to choose Emanuelle Decor.
Yeah.
Emanuelle, because God is with us, right? So this is the business name, why I choosing that. And the truth is, after when I choose this name, I got so many questions in my heart. What can I do with this business? Really, what can I do with people? How can I share God loves with people? So when I continue my question with the Lord and I'm listening, He's put so many answers in my heart. And to help for people who like to really celebrate. It's interesting because what I went through is so deep and full with pain. But what I have to do, share the love and help for people to celebrating, enjoy the life. absolutely as opposite way what I have to do, what is in my heart, you know? So
absolutely.
This is what I did, and the Lord told me I have to help for people to do wedding and mm-hmm. baby showers, let's see, or birthday party or fundraising also. And God is using us for a couple of people's life now. Thanks for God. We have some experience now, which is very nice story, with very nice connection with so many family from Sick Kids Hospital also. And short-wise, this is what is happened with us, and this is who we are. And I really like to answer any question if you have.
Absolutely. Well, I think what you've shared with us so far is very moving, and it must have taken so much courage after that family tragedy to rebuild, and also to just have that amazing connection that you have with God, for Him to reveal, you know, His purpose in your life, and taking that and starting Emanuelle Decor. You know, people may take it for granted, but that's a huge, huge leap of faith, and so much courage. So I have to say that I really respect what you did. So let's talk now about the services of Emanuelle Decor. Tell us how you are just changing the lives of people who are venturing into becoming wonderful wedded couples.
All right. If I'm doing wedding decoration, I'm a planner also, not just a decorator. So I can mm-hmm. help for couples to do everything from the beginning to the end, is including videographers, sweet tables, table setup, a hat table, backdrop, anything else what they needed, because I have a group who like to work with us and is already working for a couple of weddings together now. And thanks for God, we have a good news. The people always happy how we doing everything. But before I start, I always asking the Lord bless me and give me the wisdom to do everything well. And I really like to see when God using us and my service on people life. We are really blessed, thanks for the Lord, because what I imagine in my mind or in my heart, what I like to do it, God is always doing extra on it, and I doesn't even can explain how nice is going through all my job. But why mm-hmm. I help for people for doing wedding is very interesting ways. First of all, I like to help for any people life to make marriage, because what we believe, like a Christian, this is very important to get a blessing when couples love each other, right? But the marriage, this is not just a nice celebration for us. This is a very important connection with God, honestly, right? Plus mm-hmm. the blessing is coming when we prove that for the people we really love each other and we like to stay together forever.
Yeah.
But so many people is trying to put back a little bit to make this celebration or make the wedding ceremony or make the celebration, because financially it's so hard to stand up or figure it out how much is the budget or is enough or is maybe not, right? So this is what is giving me a big challenge. Why I saying that? Because when I meet some young couples who really like to marry, the first problem is always we don't have enough money, what we like to do it and what we imagine to like to make it on this day, it looks like very expensive. So it looks like we need 1.5-2 years when we're able to doing that. So God is giving me a very, very, very interesting job with people. I have to help for people to believe that don't need a very, very highest budget to get something nice, something special. So What I explain for people, I have so many items in my house, or also I can help for people where we can renting out together items, and let's see how we can doing that, what is running in your heart. And when I know and I writing down, I always like to give a better price for couples. So I, for me, first important, not my income. I know it may be interesting over the radio when people hearing that from me, but I love to help with love.
Okay.
This is
so you,
what
you
I
help
have.
People work out their budgets. You're very reasonable. You just want to make sure
flexible.
That they have a beautiful day. Yes.
Yes.
That's
important. Yes. Yes. Short-wise, this is what I have to do. Yes.
Fantastic.
Yes.
And I know that they are so blessed by you blessing them. Let's talk a little bit about your work in ministry. When did that start, and who have you been able to minister to?
Well, my ministry job is interesting because when I doing the help for people, my church, my main church is a Toronto Airport Christian Fellowship, Catch the Fire Ministry.
Mm-hmm.
And the truth is when I praying for people and I help for them, now I got a very, very interesting job. I'm not just have to doing wedding or celebration, I do fundraising also. But when I doing
mm-hmm.
fundraising, I help for people who have cancer children. And
mm-hmm.
when we doing the fundraising, the main point for me, sharing God loves and hope for people and sharing my testimony, what I went through. And I always have a chance to explain short-wise my story for mothers to and families. And
mm-hmm.
some ministry is also calling us to sharing our testimony, how we went through everything by faith. And this is what we're doing. So I really like to help for people don't losing hope and faith. But so many other churches calling us and give us a chance to help. And I also introduce my business and my testimony for church or ministries, because what I believe when people hearing that, what I went through with my family, is always make them stronger by faith.
Yes, yes, absolutely. Now, how have you been transformed by helping so many people? How has your life been changed?
Always change a lot.
Mm-hmm.
Totally, totally different ways. I like to tell the truth like a mother, not like a businesswoman in this time.
Mm-hmm.
Like a woman and the mother who went through a biggest pain, what the mother can see and handle it. Thanks for God, I don't have enemy in my life, but if I have, I don't wish that for them or for him, what I went through. But God is with us, and this helped me a lot how I can handle it. The truth is I don't have front of me any testimony. How can I handle it? Or how can I bury my son? Or what can I do like a Christian mothers? When I lost my son, I asking the Lord, not asking why you doing that with me or why you let him to happening this with me. I'm
right.
asking the Lord only what I have to do now.
Mm-hmm.
Is interesting, but this is the truth.
Yeah.
And
instead of saying why me, you said Lord,
no,
how can
no.
you use me, right?
Something like that. But honestly, what I have to do now? It
yeah.
means my family is big. My job is huge to keep together my family
mm-hmm.
in this
you
time.
Have a big family.
My
yeah.
children is big, and my husband is a very, very nice man, but so sensitive. And, of course,
mm-hmm.
in this time, is a shock what we got, right? It's so hard.
Yeah.
We never have accident. We never have tragedy in my life or in my
yeah.
generation. So
mm-hmm.
In this time when we are in vacation in Miami, is very hard when you try to make joy for your children and after this happening.
Yes,
but,
of course.
How is the community stand up beside me, the Spanish community in Miami, the neighborhood when we are in the vacation home, is amazing. They're collecting money. They stand up, come in front of my house, praying with us, asking what they have to help. And it's interesting, the one Canadian family is there for vacation, is a Christian family who is coming in front of my house and asking, how can I help you? Because a couple of years ago, we lost one of us, daughter, and they have a very nice prayer in the ceramic heart. Can I give it to you? And I said, thank you so much. This is a huge testimony, even if I'm going through a biggest pain in my life, but God is with me.
It's always sending his angels,
Yes, it is. He is.
Wow.
And the prayers on the ceramic heart is a serenity prayer. And it's huge help because, you know, it's explaining, even if I'm going through something, I can change it, but I have to handle it and with wisdom and faith, right? And I keep this heart for 2.5 years. And after when I got the message from the Lord, what kind of business I have to do or how I have to help for other families, I got one family on the Facebook. I have a mom and mom website in Brampton because in this time I'm living Brampton. And the ladies give me a chance to talk with her. And she explained she liked to selling some items from her house because she have a brain cancer child. After that, I got a big message in my heart, how can I help for them? And I going to help for them, not financially. Plus, we send it some toys for them, and the Lord is showing me these little kids, or most of them, is like the superheroes. So I talked with my children, what we can do, and we got a very nice chance. So we dressing up superheroes now for children, and when we see how it's help for the children, just making 5 minute joy, and how it's magical, how it's changing them, this is changing us life too.
Right.
Totally different ways.
Yeah, totally transformational from every area that you can think of. Elizabeth, you've just really really opened up my eyes to a situation that no parent wants to go through. I'm a mother of three, and I can't even imagine the depth of the pain that you experienced. But thank God for you, because he's used you in so many ways to help others by strengthening them and helping them in their pursuit for wedding bliss and planning their events and fundraising. God has really been using you, so we really thank you for being able to step up and step into the calling despite the hardship that you experienced. So thank God for you. Now, people listening, if you missed the beginning of the interview, you don't have to worry. We're going to be replaying this throughout the week, and Elizabeth is going to share with us now her contact information. How can people get in touch with you, Elizabeth?
Thank you so much. I have a Facebook page, Emanuelle Decor, and I also have my web page is emanueldecor95.com, or I have an Instagram page. People just have to using my business name, Emanuelle Decor. I have a phone number. It's my business phone number is 289-554-4144. I'm living in Markham, but I'm able to go any area in the GTA area, and I also like to give any chance to talk with me for people and free estimate what I'm doing. And I do baby shower, birthday party, and bar mitzvah also, not just wedding. And my website actually is including all the information, what we're doing, because we do so many things with balloon decoration mm-hmm. also.
Yeah.
And hopefully the people when is visiting my webpage, they can like it what we're doing. And mm-hmm. I love to help for people, love to work, love to meet new people, and sharing God love.
Okay.
So thank you so much,
thank
again,
you so
for
much.
Sharing my information and my testimony. And please forgive me if my English is not so perfect, but hopefully people understand my heart and my life.
And I think that's the most important part, Elizabeth. You share from the heart, everyone understands. I just want to thank you so much for your time. Elizabeth, you have a blessed day, and we will check in with you sometime in the middle of the year just to see how God is continuing to use you in the community. Thanks again.
Thank you so much, Nikki. God bless you.
God bless you, too. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye, dear.